afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Sui.
Thank you. You can sit down. All right. In today's lesson, the first thing we will do is look at the exercise you were given last time, last lesson, based on the applications using applications of matrices. I think you were given three questions to do, question 2, 3, and 4. I hope, okay. And then after that, we will look at solving three simultaneous equations with three unknowns using algebra first. We have to know how to use algebra before we use matrices to solve three simultaneous equations. All right, number 2, is there anyone with an answer? White, green, and brown played in a cricket match. White hit 2 sixes, 3 fours, and 8 singles. Green scored 1 six, 2 fours, and 5 singles. And brown scored no sixes, 2 fours, and 9 singles. Okay, if you set out the information correctly, you should be able to get the answer correctly. To find the total number of runs scored by each batsman. Anyone with an answer, you have to give us the runs scored by each of the batsmen, white, green, and brown. Killa?
White scored a number of 32 runs.
White scored?
A total number of 32 runs.
82 or 32?
32.
32 runs, and?
Green scored 19 runs. And
19.
Brown scored 17.
32, 19, and?
17.
17. Okay, white scored 32 runs, green scored 19 runs, and brown scored 17 runs. You all agree with Killer's answers? Yes? Okay, next one. Susan and Margaret went shopping and their purchases were as follows. They each bought meat cubes, chicken cubes, and packets of soup. Okay, Susan bought 6 meat cubes, 4 chicken cubes, and 3 packets of soup. Margaret bought 8 meat cubes, 5 chicken cubes, and 2 packets of soup. Okay, first of all, we have to write the information in the form of a 2 times 3 matrix and call it P. Okay, I want you to give me the matrix P, please. Who's going to answer this one for us? Velma.
P, the first column is 6 and 8, second, 4 and 5, third, 3 and 2.
3 and
2.
Okay, this should be the matrix P. That's a 2 by 3 matrix. Secondly, meat cubes cost 40 toya each, and chicken cubes cost 50 toya each, and soup cost 1 kina 20 per packet. We have to write this information as a 3 by 1 matrix and call it C. Jake, can you give us matrix C, please?
C equals
40, 50, and 120. Okay, then C says work out PC. Then, what is PC?
Eight and eight can attend to it. 8 and 8 kinatento ya.
Oh, 8 and 8 kinatento ya. Eight kinatento ya. And is that all? Right, the last one, it says pre-multiply PC by the raw matrix 1-1 and explain what the result means. Okay, if we multiply PC by 1-1, what do we get? Patrick?
16 kina tento.
16 kina and?
16. 16.
16 here. And 16, the next one.
No, it's just one.
I cannot hear, that's the thing. Patrick?
16 kina tento.
16 kina tentoya and?
Color.
Same one?
Just
or is
one.
That all?
Yeah, that's all.
Okay. Patrick, you also have to tell us what this means.
Total amount spent.
Okay, it means that both of them spent 16 kina, 10 toya. Okay, question 4, the last question. In a football league, City scored 1 goal in each of the 5 matches. 2 goals in each of 7 matches and 3 goals in each of 2 matches. United scored 1 goal in each of 6 matches, 2 goals in each of 5 matches and 3 goals in each of 3 matches. We have to set out the information in the form of two matrices and see them, use them to work out the total number of goals scored by each team. Okay, can we just have the 2 matrices and then the total scored by each team as well. Raylene?
First column for the first matrix are 5, 6. Second column, 7, 5. And third column, 2, 3. And for the second matrix, the first column, 1, 2, and 3.
Okay. Next, just we have to work out the total number of goals scored by each team. Danielle.
Twenty-five.
So what's the total? Scored by each team. Is that the answer, 25 and 25? Okay. The first team scored a total of 25 goals and the second team also scored a total of 25 goals. Okay then. The next thing that I want to teach you is to solve 3 equations with 3 unknowns. You're probably the only grade 11s who are being taught this one. Hopefully you will understand it and not think about your economics test. Okay, solving 3 equations with 3 unknowns. Okay, remember what we've done? We've solved 2 equations with 2 unknowns. Usually, okay, note I'm using the word usually. Usually if there are 2 unknowns, you have to solve 2 equations to find out the value of those 2 unknowns. You need 3 equations to solve for 3 unknowns. So we are going to solve x minus 2y plus 3z equals 11 and 2x plus y plus 4z equals 27. x minus 5y plus 3z equals 2. And the first thing I want to do is to use algebra, because if we don't understand that, we probably might not understand matrices and how to solve three unknowns. Just like we've solved two simultaneous equations using algebra, you now know how to solve two simultaneous equations using matrix as well. Okay, the first thing that we usually do with two equations is to number the equations, right? So I'm going to number these equations, number 1, 2, and 3. And usually I use these Roman numerals. I don't use the numbers 1, 2, and 3 like that, because when I multiply, I use these numbers, so I specifically use that. Okay, the first thing that we do, remember the two methods that we use to solve two simultaneous equations? We use either substitution or elimination. You still use those two to solve three equations. Okay, if you look at equation number 1 and equation number 2, they have coefficient of x which is equal to 1. So what we can do is actually eliminate x in these two equations. So what I'm going to do is subtract equation 3 from equation 1. Okay, so x minus x will give me 0, minus 2y minus negative 5y will give me how many y's? 3y's. Okay, so when I do that, I will get 3y, and 3z minus 3z will give me 0. That means 3y will be equal to 11 minus 2 is 9. Which means by this we can actually work out the value for y already. So if 3y is equal to 9, then y is equal to 3. Okay, the next thing to do, since I know the value for y, I can substitute to any of these two. Now I have two unknowns to solve for, which means I only need two equations. I need to solve for x and I need to solve for z. So I substitute, okay, I'm going to substitute this into equation number 1. So x minus 2y is 3. So I get 3 plus 3c equals 11. So I now have x minus 6 plus 3z equals 11, and x plus 3z is equal to 17. Clear? I need one more equation because I have two unknowns. So I'm going to call this equation number 4. I've got 1, 2, 3, and now equation number 4. I will also substitute y into equation number 2. So substitute into 2. I have 2x plus y, which is 3, plus 4c equals 27. So I now have 2x plus 4c equals 24. And I'm going to call this equation number 5. Okay, I can actually reduce equation number 5 by dividing by 2, because I can see that that's 2x and 4z and 24 have a common factor of 2. So I can reduce this one and say that's x plus 2z equals 12. I can do that. Okay, that's still equation number 4. Okay, now I can solve these two simultaneously by using what? Elimination, because this is x plus 3z equals 17 and x plus 2z equals 12. So I can now subtract. Okay, I'll call this equation number 5. I can subtract equation number 5 from equation number 4. So I will get x minus x is 0, 3z minus 2z is 1z, and 17 minus 12 is 5. Did you follow? Okay, I didn't write two of them. What you can do is write these two next to each other so that you know what you're doing. So x minus x is 0, 3z minus 2z is 1, 17 minus 12 is 5. So now I know that z is 5. And I also know that y is 3. The only thing I have to do now is to find x. So all I do is substitute again into equation number 1. Maybe we'll use number 3. Okay, substitute into 3. I don't know x, but I know that y is 3. And I know that z is 5 equals 3 times equals 2. Okay, so I have x minus 15 plus 15 equals 2, and x is equal to 2. So x is 2, y is 3, and z is 5. Okay, what you can do is substitute those three into three of these equations to see if they satisfy the equation. Okay, we'll just try by substituting into one. If I put 2 here, I get 2 minus 2 times 3 is 6, 2 minus 6 plus 15. 2 minus 6 is negative 4. Negative 4 plus 15 will give 11. Okay, try here. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 plus 20 is 27. Okay, and this one, 2 minus 15 is negative 13. Negative 13 plus 15 is 2. Okay, you are going to do one question. Since some of you are sleeping. Okay, your question is you have to solve minus x plus 3y plus 6c equals 1. X plus 5y minus 2z equals negative 5. And 3x minus 2y plus c equals 9. Okay, note if the coefficients are different, you can multiply to make them the same, just like you do with the other equations.
Worshipper of the beast. theoretical, because these coefficients are minus 1 and 1. You add them. You can't subtract this one from there because the coefficients are different. Remember elimination? You're trying to get rid of one unknown. So add the first two.
Okay, note, I subtracted equation 3 from equation 1 because the coefficients are the same. It's a I mentioned that coefficient of 1, coefficient of 1. Okay, I couldn't do it to the y's because there is no coefficient that's the same. Okay, here, what can you do? Add equation 1 and equation number 2, provided you number them first, so you know what you're doing.
Can divide by 4. Okay. Z equals, is that minus 4, positive 4? Okay, so that's minus 1. So Z is equal to, make Z the subject. If you divide by 3, you also have to divide this one by 3. So you can't. You can multiply like you do with this now two unknowns. You can multiply to make the coefficients the same. Then eliminate one.
Did anyone copy this down? Just so that the others might need the notes. Yes, okay. Okay, you will note this, that these three are slightly different from this, the one that we solved earlier. With the one we solved earlier, straight away we got y equals 3. This one won't. It won't happen if you do that. Okay, for this one, the coefficients that are the same, minus 1 and 1, so what we do is we add 1 and 2. Okay, after we do that, we get 8y plus 4z equals 1. We will call that equation number 4, which you can, this one is negative 4, which you can actually simplify. You can divide both sides by 4 and you will get 2y plus z equals negative 1. Okay, that's still equation number 4. Okay, the next thing you need to do is to solve another two equations and then come up with an equation that has only y and z in it. So what we can do is we can solve equation 3, 2 and equation number 3. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, because the coefficients are all different, I'm going to multiply equation 2 by 3 so that I can make the coefficients the same. So I'll get rid of x. So multiply 2 by 3 and I get 3x plus 15y minus 6z equals negative 15. Okay, I'm now going to solve this. Sorry, I have to call this equation number 5. I'll solve this with equation number 3. So I get 3x minus 2y plus z equals 9. This is equation number 3. So I'm going to subtract 5, take away 3. 3x minus 3x is 0. 15y minus negative 2y is 17y. And minus 6 minus z is minus 7. And I get negative 24. Okay, so I'll call that equation number 6. Okay, because I've used up to number 5. Now I'm going to solve 4 and 6 simultaneously. Okay, 4 is 2y plus z equals negative 1. Okay, what method should I use to solve the two equations? Elimination or substitution? Okay, if I want to, I can use substitution. Sorry, elimination. But I have to make the coefficients the same. I can multiply this by 7 so that I can get 7c. Or otherwise, I've got a coefficient of 1 here, so I can make z the subject of this equation and substitute it into equation number 6. So I'm now solving 4 and 6 simultaneously. Okay, so in equation number 4, I see that z is equal to minus 1 minus 2y. I substitute it into equation number 6. Okay, where's equation number 6 here? I get 17y minus 7. Okay, since z is equal to minus 1 minus 2y, I get minus 1 minus 2y equals negative 24. Okay, which is 17y plus 7 plus 14y equals negative 24. What's 14 plus 17? 31. And minus 24 minus 7 will give me negative 31. So y is negative 1. Okay, if y is negative 1, all I need to do is substitute here and I will get the value for z. So z is equal to minus 1 minus 2 times negative 1. I get minus 1 plus 2 is? Minus 1 plus 2 is 1. This marker, sir. So x is, have we found x yet? No, okay. I thought we did. I now have to substitute y and z into one of the equations to find x. Okay, I'll substitute into equation number one. Okay, equation one is minus x plus 3, y is negative 1, and z is positive 1. It's equal to 1. Okay, minus x minus 3 plus 6 equals 1. X is equal to minus 3 plus 6 is 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. So, X is 2, Y is negative 1, and Z is 1. Okay, you have a homework to do, which I will give you 4 questions. 1, 2, 3, and 4 on solving 3 equations with 3 unknowns. Okay, the keyword to the pilot teacher is 3 equations. Good afternoon, class.
I am